Hey fellow photographer, how's it going? I'm Michael Zelbel. Today I would like to show you how you use color filters in Adobe Lightroom Classic to your advantage when converting your color portraits to black and white portraits. I'm specifically talking about black and white high key portraits, which are really bright with really bright white skin tones. Yeah, so the background for this is that we talked about color filters in our Facebook group. And then a while ago, I showed you how to use color filters in Photoshop. And of course, I got the questions. Yes, Lightroom walkthrough, please. Of course, I only use Lightroom. Lightroom, please, not really a PS user. I'm super happy to show you that in Adobe Lightroom Classic. I guess most of you will use Lightroom Classic. And don't let anybody tell you that Lightroom is a less professional tool compared to Photoshop, for example. Yeah, that's not the case. I mean, the result that you get from both tools are exactly the same. And whatever gets you to your desired result fastest is the right tool. Yeah, it's not that one is more professional than the others, or pro photographers would use this but not that or something. Total rubbish. Okay, with that said, let's have a look at our example photo. And this time I will just stay in Lightroom. Now, this is a photo of our model Nakriko, and she got a pretty dark skin tone, but it doesn't matter. We can convert that to high key. Skin tone really does matter. And what we can do is two things. Yeah, I mean, most people, they would probably use a very quick way, but not very exact way. That is, they go to presets, and they add the classic black and white filters, which you can add in Lightroom. And then they've got an orange filter. And this looks nice. It's a nice black and white conversion, but it's probably not high key enough for us. So let's undo this. Or they would try the red filter, but that's probably a bit over the top. So that's also not good. And you could adjust this now, but honestly, I would just not use them to begin with. I would do this in the development module. I would scroll up to black and white, which converts my photo into black and white. And now I scroll down to the black and white mix, where I can say what color in the original photo is rendered how bright. And there I can control the skin tone with my orange channel. If I dial it up, then the whole skin is getting brighter. Let's say 60% for me, it's really nicely high key. Probably it's even over the top. Let's go to 50. And now what I probably also want to do is remove some blemishes. So let me go back to color for a second. Okay, in the color version of the photo, I see there's a lot of little red spots, and here's a red area in the face going on. And that would typically be a job for a skin filter, but a skin filter removes texture. In this black and white conversion with color filters, I probably don't need a skin filter. So let me do this move again. I go to treatment, black and white, and then I dial up orange. And what I can see now is the spots and the red areas are less prominent because everything is bright, but I can still see them. It's still really visible that there are darker spots because they were red and not orange. So what I can do to remove them completely is I dial up the red channel. And now, let's say to 90, they are practically invisible. Now I definitely don't need a skin filter anymore, and I got all the texture still inside the skin. Just because I said red spots, well, let's render them really bright. And the rest of the skin, let's render it quite bright. And the result in total is a nice high-key black and white image. So what if I don't know my skin tones anymore? I mean, it's pretty obvious. The skin is kind of orange. But anyway, let's just go to another photo from that photo shoot. Over here, we have got orange skin pretty much everywhere, but also some redness over here on her knee. There's a red scar that she got. So if I don't know where these skin tones fall, I can also do one thing. Let's go to black and white. Oh no. Let's do it once in color mode, then you see it. If I go to an orange area and I hold my mouse key and I drive the mouse up and down, then I'm moving the orange channel over here in this section. Now it's called luminance. No? If I'm on the scar, let's see where that falls. I'm moving orange and red. So it's a mixture of orange and red. Good to know. Anyway, let's go to black and white again to make it a black and white high key photo. So after the regular black and white conversion, it's kind of grayish. That's not so nice. Now I keep my color picker over here and I go to some area which is a problem area. Let's say the scar. That drives the slider up. Ooh, all the way up. Well, the scar is still a tiny little bit visible, but I would probably not even need a correction anymore. It's so subtle, it doesn't matter. And the result overall, let's give back this tool and let's zoom out. It's a nice high-key portrait. So this is the other method you can dial up and down your channels. Just use this adjustment tool over here. All right, I hope this helps you. I hope you have fun converting your color portraits to high-key black and white portraits. I really like this look. And let me know how this works for you. Let me know how you convert your photos usually to black and white. And if you need another tool like the new Lightroom CC or something, let me know, then I show you the same move over there as well. Righty, with that said, have a lot of fun, good light.